Let's continue our discussion of simplifying expressions, but with an emphasis on expressions involving fractions. So for example, let's say we wanted to simplify. Okay, let's say that we had 1/2 multiplied by x minus 4 plus 1/3 x. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start off by distributing this 1/2. So we're going to multiply the 1/2 by the x, and then the 1/2 multiplied by the negative 4. So first of all, 1/2 times x is just 1/2 x. And now 1/2 times negative 4, well, a positive times a negative is going to be a negative. So I'm looking at negative, well, whatever I get when I multiply 1/2 and 4 together. So notice how I wrote the 4 as 4 over 1, and that's because whenever you multiply two fractions together, you first of all want to see if you can cancel either vertically or diagonally, and then second of all, you're going to multiply across after that, if you recall. Okay, but I still have the plus 1/3 x there. Okay, so we're continuing with multiplication, and in this case I can cancel, right? 2 goes into 4 twice, so this becomes a 1, and that becomes a 2. And what I'm left with is 1/2 x, let's see, minus, well, 1 times 2 is 2, divided by 1, so that's just minus 2, plus 1/3 times x. Okay, so at this stage, I have three terms, and two of the terms are like terms, and I can see that because they both contain an x. So the way, the way we combine like terms is by adding their coefficients. So the coefficient of this term is a 1/2, and the coefficient of that term is a 1/3. So I have to add together those two fractions. This is a perfect opportunity for us to apply what we talked about in previous videos. So let's go off to the side over here. Let's just add together those two fractions, 1/2 plus 1/3. And if you remember what we talked about in the previous video, what's important when you're adding or subtracting fractions is that you have a common denominator. So I'm thinking to myself, okay, what's the smallest number that both 2 and 3 go into evenly? And I can see that that would be 6. So I'm going to change both of these fractions, or change both of these denominators to 6. So this is something over 6, and the next one's going to be something over 6 as well. Okay, so the question is how does 2 become 6? And you can see, you have to multiply by 3. So if I multiply the bottom by 3, I have to multiply the top by 3 as well. And 1 times 3 is 3. And likewise, how does 3 become 6? And the answer is, you multiply by 2. So if you multiply the bottom by 2, you multiply the top by 2 as well, and 1 times 2 is 2. And now that the fractions have a common denominator of 6, I can add the numerators together. And 3 plus 2 is 5, and I get 5 over 6. Now, 1/2 plus 1/3 is 5 over 6, and I use that over here because remember I was adding together the coefficients. So 1/2 plus 1/3 is the 5 over 6, but you still have the x attached, right? Because whenever you combine like terms, you keep what they have in common, in this case the x. But I still have the minus 2. So at this stage, these terms are not like because one contains an x and the other one doesn't, and so that would be as far as we can go. Okay, let's take another example now that's a little more complicated, but still involving fractions. So let's say that we wanted to simplify. Okay, let's say that we had about negative 2/3 multiplied by the quantity x plus 6 minus x over 3. Okay, so this problem has a couple of interesting issues for us to address. So just like in the previous problem, the first thing we're going to do is distribute. So we're going to distribute this negative 2/3. So remember, the negative is going with the 2/3 upon distribution. So I draw in my little arrows to indicate that I'm distributing. And I have, a negative 2/3 times x is negative 2/3 x. And then, just like before, a negative times a positive, well, that's going to be a negative. And, well, negative what? Whatever I get when I multiply 2 thirds and 6 together. So 2 thirds times 6 over 1, and then I still have the negative x over 3 there. That hasn't changed. Okay, so now let's go ahead and multiply these two fractions together. So if you recall, you don't go ahead and multiply straight across. You always look to see if you can do some canceling first. So the canceling can either happen vertically or it can happen diagonally. So can I cancel diagonally? I can, because 3 goes into both of these. So 3 goes into 3 once, and 3 goes into 6 twice. And now I have negative 2 thirds x. Okay, and then minus what? Well, 2 times 2 is 4 over 1, so minus 4 minus x over 3. Okay, so at this stage, we are going to combine like terms. Do you see the terms that are like? It would be this term and that term. And so the question you have to ask yourself is, what are the coefficients? Well, I can see clearly that the coefficient for this term is negative 2 thirds. What about this term? So when I look at this, you can always write, or you can always think of, x over 3. Isn't that the same thing as 1 third times x over 1? You can verify that that's true, right? Because 1 times x is x, and 3 times 1 is 3. Now, why would I do that? Because then I can write this, of course, as 1 third times x. When people write this with the x off to the side, it really means this. The x is actually up in the numerator. It's actually over 1, but nobody really writes that. Okay, so if you just write the x off to the side, you're thinking this. And why is that useful? Because then I can take this and replace that, so it'll make it clear what the coefficient is. So this is equal to negative 2 thirds, x still, minus 4. Okay, let's replace we have the minus, right? Now let's go ahead and replace x over 3 with 1 third x. And now, just like in the previous problem, what I have to do is add the two coefficients together. So negative 2 thirds and negative 1 third. Now, I'd like to do that off to the side because sometimes adding fractions together can be a little bit tricky. So off to the side, I'm going to say, okay, what is negative 2 thirds minus 1 third? Well, we're in luck here because the denominators are already the same. The denominators are both 3. And in that case, you put the negative with the 2, and then you subtract the other numerator. So we have negative 2 minus 1 over 3, and that's equal to negative 3 over 3, which is equal to negative 1. So what I notice is that negative 2 thirds minus 1 third is the same thing as negative 1. And that's why over here, negative 2 thirds x minus 1 third x is the same thing as negative 1 x. Negative 2 thirds minus 1 third was negative 1, and I kept the common part again. And then minus 4. And now, of course, negative 1 times x is the same thing as negative x minus 4. And that's how you simplify expressions when fractions are involved.